Mixed Blood by Nazrin Choudhury.
Thank you for coming, Razia Auntie. I know Dad really appreciated it.
You're a good girl, Sharmila. Your mother would have been so proud of you.
Yeah. Well, khudafis.
Khudafis, ma.
You look shattered.
I am. Thanks, Nish. I don't know how I would have got through today without you.
Hey, what are friends for? I just wish I could be here for you more. I know when my mum died, it helped having my brothers and sisters to go through it all with.
We should have thought of having more children, your Amma and I, no? After all, once you get married, your Baba will be all alone.
Not going anywhere, Dad.
We'll see. Oof. Well, all the guests are gone. I'm going up to say my prayers.
Okay, Dad. I'll bring you up a cup of tea in a minute. To be honest, I'm more worried about him than I am about me.
Must be hard. Sharing the same bed with someone for 25 years, then suddenly not having them there anymore.
You know that woman, the one I was just saying goodbye to?
Mm.
She's, well, she's the one who brought that marriage proposal to my parents for our son.
Guess that means you're going to have to tell your dad about Dan at some point.
I wouldn't know.
Actually, Sean, isn't that Dan's car outside?
Dan, what are you doing here?
I wanted to make sure you're okay.
Fine.
Look, I know you said you needed some space, but I just wanted to be here for you. Now, today of all days.
You shouldn't have come here.
Sharm, why are you being like this?
What is it you expect me to do, Dan? My mum's been in the ground 5 minutes. You want me to say, hey, Dad, I know Mum's just died, but here's my secret love of the past 5 years or so.
I'm not saying that. But, you know, 5 years is a long time. You can't just throw it all away because of your mum. Come on, Charm.
Don't, Dan. Look, I better be getting back. I'll call you, yeah? You are such a hoarder. Look at this stuff. I don't even know where to start. For all those years, she moaned at me for not clearing up my junk.
Don't you think it's a bit soon to be doing all this?
I want to go through it. Get it all sorted. That's what she'd expect.
You do know you can talk to me, don't you? About what's happened. I've been there, you know.
I'm fine.
I know you and your mum had your problems, but
honestly, I'm okay.
Well, if you won't talk to me about it, then at least talk to Dan. It's good to get it all out.
Dan and I are on a bit of a break.
What? Why? When?
Dan isn't my only option, you know.
Oh, no way. You can't seriously be telling me you're actually considering this wish, are you?
Why not? It's what Mum wanted, and there's my dad to think about.
Oh, I don't believe this.
It's not as crazy as it sounds. This guy, he's from a good family, well-educated. It'd make life a hell of a lot easier.
Good family? Well educated. Gee, Sharm, you're starting to sound like your mum.
Look, I haven't said that's what I'm definitely going to do, have I? Anyway, I thought you were supposed to be helping me with this lot.
I am. Look, why don't you make a start on that box over there? I'll go and make some coffee.
Thank you, Brady.
It's okay, Uncle.
You're a good girl looking after your uncle. And Sharmila too. I know they had their difficulties while your auntie was still alive, but now that she's gone, eh?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.